A big issue in the music industry over the last few years has surrounded the concept of the re-record, which is where an artist chooses to re-record their hits in order to gain ownership in their works. Now, I've heard several rounds of re-records, and I fully support the intent, taking back ownership of your art, especially if you were screwed in the original deal. But don't be lazy in the re-record process. At least take it a step above a karaoke performance. For example, Jagged Edge released a Greatest Hits compilation where everything was re-recorded. And it sounds like they took a karaoke CD of their songs, booked a studio session, and knocked it out in a day. Don't get me wrong, their vocals are still there. But as a seasoned music fan with a production background, prefer the originals. Boyz II Men did the same thing with their 20 album, where they re-recorded their classic hits. The problem is that the bass of their group left years ago, so they were doing three-part harmonies when it was originally four. In the case of TLC, they were having a ton of sample clearance issues while producing their biopic, Crazy Sexy Cool, the TLC story. In order to proceed, they had to re-record each one of their hits that was featured in the movie. Now, these were fairly close since both ladies pretty much sound the same, but you could tell the difference based on subtle production differences in addition to the amount of auto-tune they used. Then we have the case of JoJo, whose efforts were much more noble because her music wasn't available anywhere. Without getting into the deeply layered drama of it all, which really should be its own movie, her former label essentially silenced her for several years, and she had to fight them in court for several more to even be able to sing professionally again. At the same time, the label removed their entire repertoire from the digital stores and streaming services, and all of their physical products are out of print. So as soon as she could, JoJo re-recorded everything she had ever done on that label and released it all at the same time. Two full albums and two additional singles. Now, JoJo can sing a lot of people under the table, and her recent Grammy win is well deserved, so JoJo fans, don't come at me. But I felt like she dialed it in on the re-records. My first thought is that she locked herself in the studio and did all of the vocals in a few days from top to bottom, to the point where I could tell she was vocally tired halfway through but kept going. I wasn't far off because her Up Rocks documentary confirmed that she was doing two songs a day to get it out. And the production on a lot of the tunes were more like karaoke versions, so I tend to just go to YouTube and listen to the originals. At some point, I'll pull out the original CDs and transfer them to my phone. And yes, I still have CDs, don't judge me. I'd still have my iPod if it hadn't died. Now, there are a lot of legalities when it comes to re-recording songs that were initially done under a standard recording agreement. For starters, you have to make sure that you can legally do so, and that the agreement term has indeed passed. You'll have to relicense the compositions from all of the writers and publishers of the songs, and clear any samples that you'd want to reuse since it's essentially a different master recording. But most importantly, you'd have to make sure that the new recording is distinct enough from the original that the two can't be confused. So in this case, every one of the cases that I mentioned has been successful, but where they fell short is in the execution. The production value was not at the same quality, despite the cost of recording being significantly cheaper than it was when the originals were recorded. And the vocal performances tended to either be dialed in, heavily auto-tuned, or just not produced well. It's unfortunate because each artist had the opportunity to take their old repertoire and breathe new life into it, make it better than it was. Now, this is all coming from a music snob, so these new versions are probably fine to the casual listener. But I'm sure all of their fans, like me, know the difference. And if we're honest, we prefer the originals.